Hello everyone, it's CR back again. And in this video, I'm going to be showing off my virtually waterproof 30 items, more or less, pocket survival kit, which addresses the rule of threes, has the 5 C's, and parts of the 10 C's. All right. Now, before I get into the contents of my setup, I'm gonna do 2 shoutouts on this video. The first one is to Arm Rogue. If you haven't subscribed to that channel yet, go ahead and check out the content. If you enjoy my content, you'll most likely enjoy the content of Arm Rogue. It has lots of content about survival, a couple of reviews here and there. You can check out the 365 video playlist. And the second shout out is to Steps to Survival, who is actually one of my first subscribers to my channel. And that channel has a lot of DIYs, tips, a couple tricks here and there, how to's. So if you join my channel, go subscribe and check out Arm Rogue and Steps to Survival. They got awesome channels. As you can see, it's in a baggie, one of those resealable type of baggies, right? Something like beef jerky or frozen food, or maybe some figs. Something like this will work quite well. Let's open it up. First thing you'll see is I got some parachute cord here with a Ranger band bicycle inner tube around it. At the ends, I have the arbor or the Canadian jam knot on both ends, so I can use it as a sash or as a handle for the kit itself. And of course, I can use the cordage for any other number of reasons. Now let's pull out the kit here. Of course, I can use resealable baggie for whatever uses, you know, store water, find wild edibles, store tinder inside. And here's my little tin here, just a 25-cent yard sale find that I got. Now around it, I got 2 Ranger bands, bicycle inner tube, and one of those bracelet bands around it. Fire starting, most likely, but just to probably most likely for me to be using as to keep the tin kind of shut. But like I said, I can use it for fire starting if I needed to. Now on the bottom here, I got half a compact here. You'll see that there's a magnet right here. And this side is actually the magnification side of it, so I can use it with solar for solar ignition, or use it for any number of reasons I would use STE for. All right, let's open up the kit now and see what's on the inside here. In no particular order, right here I got a double-sided mirror, so I can use that for signaling. Since it's broken, I can use one of the edges to scrape off some scrape some wood for some shavings, for some tinder, for example. You know, kind of use it as an improvised cutting tool. Next here, I got some parachute cord. It's in a zippered chain center, just to keep it compressed, right? Trail marking tape, so I can, you know, mark the trail, use it for signaling. Right here I got a little magnet, which I can use with the needle that I have in this setup, so I can make an improvised compass if I need to. Here's just a generic type of multi-tool. It's got saw blade, a saw, knife, Phillips head, straight edge, can opener, bottle opener, that kind of stuff. Next here I got an orange Bic lighter without the safety on it. It's orange, so I can easily see it, see the fluid level if I need to. It's got some jute twine around here, so I can use that for cordage. Make a tinder bundle or bird's nest if I need to. Fluff it up, you know, take a little strand off and just fluff it up and, you know, get this big fluffy pile of jute twine. Next here I got my paper firelock. This is a wax version, so obviously for fire starting. Next here I got around with the Ranger band and the baggie. I have three yellow balloons in here, so I can use that for signaling through sound and through visually, right? And I have three of them, so I can put them into a little triangle type of formation, use that for signaling. Hold water inside of them, use it for fire as emergency waterproof fire tinder. Next here I got a recycling bag. Why I chose this over the common black garbage bag is because this is easier to be seen with, right? And of course I could do a number of different things from collecting water, shelter, emergency cordage by making it into a tarn and braiding it into a zipper chain in it. So a number of different uses for something like that. And it's in a baggie just to keep it kind of together. And of course I can use the baggie too for a number of reasons. Now I have some fishing line here, good for fishing, lashing, that kind of stuff. Got a needle in here, good for stitching up, sewing, repairing any of the gear I have, any of the clothes I have with the fishing line or with the parachute cord. The fishing hook, self-explanatory right here. I got that hot glue around the tip so it doesn't poke through the plastic or through any of the other stuff I have inside and I don't poke myself. Here's a kind of a razor blade right here. It's sharp on both sides, so if I wear out the one side, I can use the other side. Alcohol swab here, or one of those alcoholic prep pads. So I can use this for first aid, fire starting. Next here I got about, I think it's about 3 feet, 3 to 4 feet of metal wire. So I can use that for snares, use it to make a handle for something. If I needed to, use it for lashing if I needed to. Next here I got two adhesive bandages, also known as plasters if you guys are watching from the UK. And underneath I got a larger adhesive bandage or adhesive pad right here. Next here I got some blue duct tape. Make repairs on the shelter, use it as emergency fire starting if I needed to. Lots of good uses for something like tape. Next here I got a strike anywhere match fire starter, which goes well with the four strike anywhere matches I have in here. Now, here's a little tip for you guys here. If you have a lighter, you don't need a striker for one of these. Just use the wheel as your striker. Hold it down like so and strike your strike anywhere match along this. Right? And strike that phosphorus right here, and it'll actually light up. You might have to put your thumb there or nail there so it doesn't spin, but it'll work. Next here I got four nails. So I can use that for shelter making. Let's say if I'm trying to split like a piece of wood like this thick, I can nail it in and try to split it or pull it apart with the nails, right? Use it as an improvised spearhead, for example. I could do that too. A number of different reasons I could use something like this. Next year, I got a birthday candle inside of straw just to keep the wax contained, right? So out in the summer or in high heat, I don't have to worry about this kit. I don't have to worry about the candle melting over the place. And of course, the straw can be used as fire starters too. So, you know, I could use this as a flame extender, right? Use the bag, light the candle, use the candle to light the fire. Or to light the tinder, I should say, to make the fire. Speak of fire, here's something that I don't usually see a lot of, is charred material. Now inside of this, I got charred punk wood inside. So if the lighter dies, right, I can use something like this to start my fire. It's sealed, so moisture or humidity won't affect it, so it'll keep it nice and dry. And I got quite a bit of it in there. So I can add this into like my tinder bundle that I'd be making with like the jute twine, for example, and go from there. Next here, I got another baggie, and this has about two or three coffee filters inside. So I can use that for, well, to pre-filter large debris from my water before I boil it. You know, if the water is extremely muddy, you know, pre-filter it would definitely help. Because I don't want to drink mud. Use it as emergency tinder if I wanted to. Since it's white, you know, maybe I could use it as emergency signaling too, if I needed to. And of course, I could wrap this around my face, around my mouth area, you know, make an improvised mask or dust mask if I needed to. Safety pin, self-explanatory, fishing hook things together. Lastly here, besides the tin, I got some foil. So I can make an emergency cup, use the metal wire to make a little handle for it, fold this into an origami type of cup, and go from there and boil some water. Of course, the bottom of the tin, right? I can boil water in this if I needed to, too. And the other side of it, I can use for signaling purposes. It's quite reflective. Now, if you really enjoyed it, give me a big thumbs up and hit like. If you're new to my channel, hit subscribe so you can check out the latest content from me and check out any of my previous videos I've done. Now, as the world changes, so must oneself. To reach a new level of skill and knowledge, one must practice. Because unfortunately in this world, one person can't help everyone. But one person can help someone in this world. Alright guys, so thank you for watching this video, and catch you next time. Peace.